Hi, beautiful angels. This is Mystic C from Magic Winds Tarot, and this is your most requested charms picker card reading. Yes, friends, many of you requested this reading. Here it is now. Who you will marry and what is their personality, what is their nature, and I have my bag of charms here. Yes, friends, so we are going to look into detail today. Who you will marry. I'm super excited to do this reading, and I hope you're also excited. And this is a general reading, friends. It may or may not resonate, so take whatever resonates, leave the rest behind. Also, it is a timeless reading, friends. Whenever you watch it, it is going to help you out. Make sure to subscribe Magic Winds Tarot, friends. Subscribe, like, and share. Even though I'm not well, I'm still recording, so friends, please give us a like, subscribe, and share. Thank you so much for supporting. And join us on Instagram as Magic Winds Tarot. To buy a personal reading, visit our website www.magicwindstarot.com, friends. And so that's it for now. This is a charms reading, friends, as all of you requested. So let's take a deep breath, relax, take a deep breath, and choose option number one, this beautiful red card. Option number two, this beautiful number two red card. Option number three, this beautiful number three red card. So relax, take a deep breath, friends, and choose option number one, option number two, option number three. I will leave the timestamps, friends, in the comment section, so you can directly go there and skip to the options, or you can watch the entire video. You can also choose more than one pile, friends. Yes, you can choose more than one pile if you feel drawn towards that. So let us see. Option number one, let's see who you will marry. Let's see that. So option number one, let us see who you will going to marry. These are your advice, this is the advice. These are your oracle messages. We're going to look at them shortly. And your charms, I have my bag of charms here. Let's see pile number one, who is it you will marry? Let's see. Ooh, wow, pile number one. Ooh, you have faced a lot of challenges in your love life. Trust me. It's been really tough for you, friends. A lot of people have broken your trust. A lot of people have broken your faith. I feel that you are very loving. You are very, very kind. And I know it's about who you will marry, but this is the first thing I'm getting, friends, that pile number one, you guys are very sweet. You guys are very loving, honest, trustworthy. But many people took advantage of you. Or someone actually betrayed you. You kind of lost your faith in love and marriages, but it things do get better, that's what I want to tell you. Seven of Swords. Yeah, right now I feel like you are not even ready to get married, or you feel like you don't trust people very well. You are not very sure or confident, should you marry or should you not marry? So there is this idea of, there is this notion, there is this a strange, you have trust issues, friends, honestly, and it's not your fault. If people betray, people, if you have been betrayed many times, you are definitely going to feel this way. So that's exactly how you are feeling. You feel like even if somebody trustworthy comes, you are like, nah, it's not true. People have cheated on you. So I'm sorry for that, but that's the first thing I'm getting. So let's see who you will marry. Let's see that. Oh wow, Six of Cups. So the person you will marry is going to be somebody who will be your soulmate, who will seem very similar to you. In fact, they will be like you, trustworthy, caring, loving, innocent, sweet. And it will be a relief to you, friends. It will be a very, you will feel very relieved when you meet this person, because they are your soulmate. You have a past life connection with them. But at the same time, you will feel like, that finally somebody can, you know, you can trust that person and they can trust you, because you know, you guys are like two sweet children together. So it's a very innocent connection, a very beautiful connection. For some of you, this person may be somewhere, maybe from where you, you know, your childhood home, your childhood city or country, or they belong to that country or city, but they may currently not living there. So this person will remind you of something sweet, the person you will marry. Also, they will kind of take care of you, you know, since the start. This person will be very protective of you, the person you will marry, because they know the hardships you have faced, and they are also like you. Their natural instinct is to protect, to love, to care. So you'll really enjoy with this person, a very, very sweet connection, friends. And yes, I do feel that this person will actually be your soulmate, someone you have shared your past life with, and they are very much like you, friends. And in fact, you know, very different from the people you have met in the past. So very interesting connection. What else? Three of Rods. Yes, I do feel this person you will marry, you know, maybe living in some another city or country, even though if they are from your country and city, like you guys have something common with this person, but this will be, you know, this person will expand your horizons. This person who will come into your life, they will open your mind, they will open your heart, they will help you to trust people, trust in love, in life. So, you know, you will find it very nice, you will find it very happy. Also, you will feel very excited with this person, you know, that yes, this is a relationship that can last a long time. You can count on this person, you can count on this relationship. And the person you will marry, they will be very futuristic, you know, in the way like they think about the future, they dream about the future. They are very dreamy, they are very poetic, they are very romantic also as a person, and very, very future oriented in the manner like, you know, this person will plan, like once they meet you and they, if even if they are your, you know, in courtship, you guys are, this person is like, see, when we get married, we'll do this, we'll do that, we'll have this home, we'll do this. Lots of plans, a dreamer, a beautiful person, friends, very, very beautiful person. Let's see what else. Seven of Rods. Wow. So this person that you are going to marry, they are never going to give up on you. They are someone who protects people. They are someone who defends people, and they don't give up easily. Even though, you know, you, and this is something you need actually, because people give up on you very easily, or people kind of betrayed your trust. So this person who doesn't give up, that will be such a relief to you. It will be like, you know, a soothing relief for your, you know, wounds, your hurts and pain. Another thing I'm feeling is the person you will marry, you know, they are a fighter. They are a very, very strong person. Physically, they are very fit, and mentally, they are very, very strong, friends. Mentally, this person is very strong, the person you will marry. They have taken a lot of challenges in life, you know. Just like you have faced a lot of difficulties, the person you will marry, they have also faced challenges in their life. But they have never, you know, they have never been disappointed, or, you know, challenges does not stop your person from going forward, from coming and, you know, coming towards victory. So this person is someone who never gives up, who is not afraid of a challenge. They are a fighter, they are a warrior. Ten of Pentacles. Yes, the person you will marry, probably you will meet them through family, through friends, or, you know, even, you know, even if you meet them through work, which I do feel some of you might meet this person through your work or through common work friends or work colleagues. But, you know, this person will feel like family the minute you meet them and connect with them. I also feel this person is very family oriented. They have a large family, a very big family, a very rich family. They come from a very wealthy family. A lot of money is there. I also feel your person you will marry is very close to their grandparents. He or she is loved a lot by their grandparents. So It will be a wonderful thing, you know. That's why this person is so giving. They are so kind and so happy. So, yeah. And I also feel that the family, your person, you know, the person you will marry, their family is very loving and very caring. And you will mix well in the family, you know. The family will be very affectionate towards you. So, it will be a wonderful thing. Also, this person is very rich. You will marry. They are very rich. And they have very good values. They believe in family. They believe in harmony, relationships, love, you know, husband, wife, you know, traditions, culture, all those kind of things. This person is a believer and you will really like that thing. You know, this person is not someone who just dates people randomly. No, they have very strong values, very, very cultured, very, very... I don't know how to say, even, you know, very cultured, a gentleman, a gentlewoman, you know. Knight of Rods. So this person could be an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius person that you will marry, or a Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus person. I also feel this person will be quite passionate about sports, about money, about their work, about achievements, about success. You know, this person is quite hardworking and they have a specific sense of style. Like, you know, I feel red is their favorite color, because today also, I never usually use this red card, but today I was guided to use these red cards. So red is their favorite color. Golden, yellow and red, these are their favorite color. And you can see there is a lot of yellow in these cards. Yellow, 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 yellow. So a lot of yellow and reds. And yellow is like, this person is very lucky also, friends. Money comes to them easily. Success comes to them easily. Anything they work on, it, you know, they have faced challenges, opposition, but they are still very lucky, I would say, you know. Sometimes they face a challenge once or twice, but more or less, they are very lucky. Three of Pentacles. This person has a, you know, they are very giving. The person you will marry, they are very kind. They are very cooperative. This person likes to team up and do things together. They don't want to do things alone, you know, like, hey, just go alone and do your own thing. I'll do my own thing. No. This person is someone who is like, let's do, let's plan, let's go for a picnic, let's take our families also, let's do this, let's do that, you know, together. Cooperation is must for this person. Another thing I'm feeling is this person could be an architect, this person could be a manager, a banker, someone who deals, he or she could be running a family business. And I do feel they come from a very important family, or a family that's known, very widely known also, like a politician or maybe, you know, business families. Their family, like, you know, like everyone in their family is a doctor, so their family is known. Everyone in their family has a business, so their family is known. You know, this person is, could be an architect, could be a manager, could be a businessman, a businesswoman. So those are the profession. And Queen of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. I feel this person is the person you will marry. They are very romantic, very, very romantic. And if she's a woman, she's even more romantic and, you know, very, very beautiful looking. You're gonna fall head over heels in love because, you know, they are so sweet and so vulnerable. And, you know, you're gonna really feel very attached to this person, you know, that you are going to marry. There is a beautiful, this person you will marry has a beautiful heart. You know, they are a very kind spirit, very loving spirit. And... very, very romantic also in their, you know, they are very romantic in their heart. They don't show this to many people, but they are very romantic. Ten of Rods. Yeah, I feel like, you know, the main thing that you need to remember is that the person you will marry, they are very hardworking. And they have a lot of responsibilities, work responsibilities, or they come from a big family, a joint family or something, or they are very connected to their family, very close to all their family. Even if they live away from them, they are very close to them. So, you know, this person will have certain responsibilities of work, of family, and they will expect you to understand those things, you know, expect you to understand those responsibilities, those commitments this person has made. So that will be necessary. Another thing is, just as you are very giving, this person is also a giver. So sometimes they may end up giving too much, and that needs to be balanced in this connection, because you both are giving, it is wonderful, but sometimes this person might take up a lot of burdens and not say no to you or anybody else. So that needs to be balanced. And the Two of Cups, oh my God, look at that. You guys are soulmate, a perfect match, a match made in heaven. This is beautiful, friends. And this person will restore your faith. You know, this person will actually help you feel like, you know, finally you have arrived. Finally, you have found what you were looking for. And this person, you know, you will not trust them initially. But once you, the more you get to know them, you will fall head over heels for them. They are your perfect half. They could be your twin flame. They could be your soulmate. And you guys will have a beautiful marriage and relationship, friends. It is amazing. You guys are perfect together. Let's see what else. And then we're gonna look at the charms. Please excuse my throat. It's getting better. But it is taking some time because I keep speaking and doing these, you know, readings. Yeah. So let's see who you will marry. Let's see that. Perseverance, someone who never gives up. Wow. So this person you will marry, they are never going to give up on you or this connection. Even when things are tough, they will wait for things to get better and they will work to make this partnership, this relationship beautiful. It will be a very strong marriage, a very strong, a loving connection for you, friends. And I know that I can do whatever I set my mind to. So this person, they are a warrior. The person you will marry, they are very strong-willed. And even if you are, you know, even if you take some time to trust this person or open up to them, they won't give up. They will stick with you through thick and through thin. So let us see what else, how you, you know, what else will be in the about the person you will marry. Fork in the road, number 13. So I feel number 13, 4, number 4, 13, 31, and 11 and 12 are important for you. And the month of April and March, I'm also getting, they are important. Fork in the road, yes. I do feel, you know, this marriage and this meeting this person will be will bring a positive change in your life. Like, you know, right now you feel like nothing good will happen in your life. There are no trustworthy people. But once you meet and get married, you will definitely feel that life is different. Life is beautiful. There are good people. And when you say those things, you know, there are no good people. Remember, there is still good in you, friends. If you are a good person, there is still good people in the world. And that's exactly what this person will remind you. Unfinished symphony, number 10. Yes, I do feel this person is somebody you have known in the past life. They have, you know, a very sweet contract with you of caring you and protecting you. And, you know, you guys love each other, friends. And definitely you guys are meeting again to fall in love and get married. And there will be, music will be important in this marriage. Maybe you both are musicians, artists, creative people, or you will raise children who are very talented and gifted artistically. So now I have added two cards for how your marriage life will be. You know, how your married life will be with this person. Let's see that. And then we're going to look at your charms. Rabbit. Oh my God. So your married life will be very passionate, friends. There will be a lot of passion, a lot of excitement, a lot of mutual attraction between you and the person. And never a dull moment in this relationship, you know. There's a lot of emotional connection and emotional harmony, compatibility. You know, you guys are very compatible. And I do see your honeymoon will be exceptional, you know. Very, very beautiful, very romantic, very magical. And the toad, the frog. It will be like, you know, I think you have kissed a lot of frogs in the past, friends. You know, a lot of wrong people. You have loved a lot of people. But, you know, this person is your Prince Charming or your Princess Charming. So don't worry. You know, your good luck is coming. And also, this marriage will keep on growing, you know, keep on growing. It is like things will never get dull in this marriage. You know, frogs, they keep leaping into things, you know, they leap, they jump. So you might feel like, you know, you don't want to get married, you're not ready for love, but once you jump into this marriage, you'll be like, this was the best thing I ever did in my life. So woohoo. And this marriage, there will be a lot of things you will learn together, you know, shared things, you will, you know, sing together, make food together, you know, sing for each other, all those kind of romantic things. So wonderful. Let's see your romance angels and then your charms, friends. Ooh, finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. So, ooh, yeah, I do feel that currently you are not in a mood to focus on your love life, on marriage or trusting people, because, you know, you are trying to recover from these past hurts and you are trying to become independent. You are trying to focus on your finances. You are trying to focus on your career right now. But as soon as you are ready to open your heart to love, this person will come and this marriage will happen. So let's see, friends. Let's see your charms. Who is the person you will marry? Pile number one. Who is the person you will marry? Pile number one. Ooh, nice. Let's see. Not many initials came, but let's see. The bell has come, the wedding bell, which is very interesting. All right, so the initials are HT and G, GHT. So the person's name could be from GHT. I keep getting the name Hiten, Hitesh, and Gracie, Tina, Tyra, or, you know, I don't know, Taylor, you know. Gracie, I keep getting the name Gracie, and Granny also is important. Maybe they have a strong connection with their grandmother, or you are very close to your grandmother. Number 99 is important. So number 999 is important. This is also, September might be important for you, friends. Another thing is, I feel like number 9 is also important in things, this phase of singlehood is ending. Now good things will happen for you, friends. Wedding bell, yes, it is coming. It's gonna happen very soon. You might meet this person in a marriage also. Some function, some marriage, some other person's marriage. This pink bead, there will be a lot of love. This blue bead is about this person is very intelligent. They are very well cultured, very well behaved. And pink is about love. A lot of love is there. And this red car is this person's favorite color is red. Maybe they have a red car, or they want to buy a red car. I also feel they are very passionate. Yes, very passionate. And another car, they are very wealthy. The person you will marry is very wealthy, or even after marriage, you will come into a lot of wealth. This pink hat, they are very romantic. They'll take care of you, friends. They'll take care of you. They'll take you out on a date. Cook food, you know, do romantic things for you. So yeah, wow, the crown. So this person will definitely treat you like a princess or a prince, like an empress or an emperor. Wonderful. They will really value you, friends. And what else? The iron is like this person will fix everything in your life, will fix your broken heart. So I keep getting that song from Coldplay, Fix You. And so this person knows how to fix you, you know, in the way heal you. the moon, yes, so you will have some, you will take some time to trust them or to open your heart to them because you have been through a lot. What else? Mushroom, again, very, 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 very sexual connection. There is a lot of sexual chemistry. The, you know, you guys will be so much in love that I feel you will have kids very soon, very quickly, without even planning. And there is this leaf and it reminds me of baby feet. So early, you know, quick babies will happen. Owl, very intelligent, a strong telepathic connection. The bird nest, wow, this is beautiful, friends, the bird nest. So again, the bird nest is a very romantic connection, you know. This is a very romantic connection. There is a lot of, you guys are the like the lovebirds, you know, that's how it is. Casablanca is a movie. I think that might be important. Movies, you might have some specific, you know, common movies which you will enjoy. The heart, very romantic person, very, very romantic. The boot, this person is a traveler or they are in a work where they are very busy. They have to travel a lot. Again, the bicycle. Yeah, this person could be a fitness freak or they, you know, when you meet, you guys both will, you know, do have shared hobbies, music, you know, dancing, you know, shared hobbies. So that is also there. So that is also cycle. Also, this reminds me of the pram, you know, children, childbirth. So that is also there. The snowflake. Wow. Very magical connection, friends. Very magical. Let's see what else. Knight of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And we have the Knight of Wands here. Here is the card. Here is the charm. Knight of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sag person. Queen of Coins, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus person. We have a Queen of Cups here. And the Two of Coins. Yes, I do feel you will take some time, friends, in opening up or saying yes to this person. Ten of Wands. We already have the Ten of Wands here also, friends. So yeah, there is, you know, this person is very hardworking. A lot of hard work. One of Ace of Wands. Lot of passion. A new start for both of you. Time. Yes, this person is coming very quickly into your life. Giver. Yes, this person is kind like you. They are very giving. Five of Wands. You know, there is, I do feel you will need some other people also or some other proposals. Five of Wands is competition. So there might be other people like you, other proposals or other people in your life. But this person is the right one for you and they are the one you will marry. And what an amazing person, friends. Hats off. Congratulations. That's it for now. Subscribe Magic Wens Tarot, like and share. Join us on Instagram to buy a personal reading. Visit our website. This is Mystic C saying bye-bye for now. So friends, let's see if you chose option number 2. Who is that? Who is the person you are going to marry? This is a charms reading. Yes, friends. Let us see. These are your oracle messages. And I will be pulling your charms shortly. So let us see who is the person you are going to get married to. Let us see. Wow. Well, I think right now, pile number 2, you are feeling very excited about your life or you are looking, you're trying to manifest a new lover, a new relationship, or you're trying to find someone who is perfect for you. You're trying to manifest, you're trying to call in your soulmate, your twin flame. And that's a wonderful energy. And pile number 2, that is actually, number 2 is about harmony. Number 2 is trying to attract love, trying to you know, find someone to spend your life with. So I do feel you are currently, you know, it's not like you are dating or you are trying to meet people. It's like maybe you are, but for most of you, you are trying to pray. You are trying to manifest your life partner, your soulmate, which is a wonderful energy. And I do feel that this energy is picking up pace or will pick up pace for you. So wonderful energy. And I feel the person you are going to marry is somebody who is very energetic, someone who is very youthful, full of optimism and vibe and, you know, full of love and charisma. They could be a fire sign, they could be any sign, but they are very, very optimistic and they are full of energy, a live wire, so wonderful. And I do feel if you are not feeling this way, you are also moving into this energy of, you know, feeling excited about life, feeling trying to manifest, you know, a lover, a dream, a soulmate relationship, a marriage partner. So you are getting excited about love again, and that's a wonderful energy. So let us see who is it that you are going to marry, and then we're going to look at your other cards and your charms. Knight of Cups. So the person you are going to marry is going to propose you first. They are going to meet you first, and they will be the first to confess their love and their feelings for you. I also feel they are very, very romantic. They could be a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, and they could be any sun sign, but I feel they have a lot of planets in Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, friends. You know, a lot of planets, like their moon sign is in Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, or their Venus sign is in Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, or their rising sign could be in a water sign. A wonderful, very, very dreamy, very, very sweet person is coming towards you, and I do feel there could be someone who sweep you off your feet, you know, someone who comes out of the blue and sweeps you off your feet, and before you know, you guys are married. So a wonderful energy is there, and I feel like this person is a chaser, someone who likes to chase, someone who likes to, even if she's a woman, I feel she will be very bold and she will be the first to tell you like she likes you and she is interested in you. So that person, you know, is going to be your future husband, wife. They are very caring, they are very loving, romantic, and very bold and expressive. This person likes to express. And let me just take a sip of water. My throat is like, oh my God, but there are so many problems happening in the world, friends. I guess this is one of the least problems we can ever have, you know, a bad throat. Yeah, that's perfectly fine, because I know the problems you all and most of the other people have dealt with. It's been... So this is fine, right? So let's get back to the reading. So the person you will marry is someone who is very expressive. They will like to, they like to take first moves, you know. They are an inspiration, a leader. They like to chase, they like to move first, you know, express their love, very communicative. Let's see, Eight of Rods. Yes, this person is someone who is very focused. They are very active. They have a lot of energy, the person you will marry. And they are also someone who is, you know, always energetic. They are moving from one goal to another, one job to, not like one job to another, like they are busy. They are very busy people. They are very productive. This person is someone who has a lot of plans in their day. Like they wake up, they go to the gym, then they go to the office, then they come back, they go for a massage, they go for a hair salon, they go for outing with friends, then they go for a dinner and, you know, sleep, yoga, meditation. This person is someone who is very active. So you will never feel like this person is someone who is not active or someone who is not moving around a lot. They could be in a fitness freak also. I also feel they are mentally very active, you know. Mentally this person is like, let's do this, let's do that, you know, a lot of plans, a lot of talking, very excited, like a happy child, like a youthful energy. They could be younger in age than you, or even if they are your age group, this person is someone who is very energetic, very youthful. And no matter their age, this person you will marry is very active from their mind, very active, very fertile mind, very fertile imagination. And I feel they will like to talk a lot with you. You guys will have a lot of discussions, long night talks, long night, walking and talking together. There's a lot to talk and share with each other. And the Four of Cups, yes. I do feel that the person you will marry is somebody, who likes to have a choice in life, you know. They like luxury, they like somebody, you know, they are a person who wants to achieve a lot many things. This person is not someone who will be satisfied with less, no. This person is someone who likes fame, who likes success, and they want a luxury, you know, a comfortable life, and they will work hard to achieve it also. So I do feel this person is someone who doesn't, they have so much of energy, and that's why they have so many goals, so many dreams. They could be doing 2-3 jobs, or like they have a business or like a job, and they also have some side hustle. They also like, you know, they have many plans in their kitty. Like they have a dream, you know, to open a business also. They might be working, but they might be studying, but you know, they have a plan to do this, do that. Even if they are working, they have a plan to study also, learn many new things. So they are constantly constantly improvising, constantly moving forward. Also, they like a comfortable lifestyle. I also feel that this person you will marry, they have, you know, they are very idealistic. They feel like, you know, they have a very large heart. They live life very large heartedly. And I also feel this person does not lose, and they don't, I don't know how to say this, the person you will marry, when they lose, they actually take it to their heart. They are not a good loser, you know. So anytime they lose or they face a setback, they take a while. They are very emotional. They take a while, you know. They get hurt easily, but they will come out of it sooner and later. But they do get very, you know, upset when they lose in life, especially at work or in sports and all those kind of things. Queen of Swords, so wow, this person you will marry, they are very intelligent, they are very learned. Even if they are not even if they are not like a scholar or something or a researcher, they are someone who knows how life is, you know. They are very sharp, they are very clever, how to live life, how to be around people. This person is very intelligent. I do feel they could be a teacher, they could be a scientist, or someone who is doing PhD in any kind of a subject. I also feel they could be someone from IT, dealing with technology, surgeons, you know, doctor field, medical field, nurses. They are very intelligent, friends, very intelligent. And I do feel that the person you will marry, they, you know, they have a very strong attachment with their mother. Their mother was very independent, or their mother raised them in a very specific way. And whether she's a man or a woman, she has a relationship with the mother. It may or may not be good, but there is something related to the mother is very important. The person you will marry is raised by a woman or mother who is very strong. And that is why this person is also very hardworking, a good achiever, but they don't like to lose because their mother would not approve of them losing, you know. They would always like win, try again, win, you know. So that's why, you know, they have a strong attachment with their mother. And the Devil, I do feel this will be a very, very passionate connection for you. The person you will marry, they'll be very passionate, very, very good looking, absolutely gorgeous man or a woman. Drop dead gorgeous, and you guys will feel this intense physical attraction with each other, physical passion. And sometimes you may even worry, you know, why this connection is there is too much sexual energy, too much attraction. But you know, you guys are meant to be friends. This is the person you will marry. So there is supposed to be a sexual attraction, a physical chemistry, but this will be even more higher in this case, in this pile, especially in this pile, because the energy is like, look at this orange. It's like, firstly, this person has a lot of charisma, a lot of sensuality. If she's a woman, she's very sensual, deep dark eyes, you know, black hairs, a voluptuous body, sexy body, very sassy. If he's a man, very good looking, very, very sexy. You know, people are attracted to them, the person you will marry. So there might be a bit of jealousy here, because they might feel very, you know, protective about you. You might feel protective about them, because there is this, people want them, you know. People will talk about this relationship you have, this marriage you have. Also, I feel like they could be from a different religion and culture, and this relationship or marriage might be of different age groups, or you guys might be of the same sex relationship, you know, same sex marriage. So, you know, it might be a talk of the town, you know. People will talk and like, oh, look, so inspiring, you know, they did this, you know, they are amazing, look at them, they are look at this couple, they are perfect, they are made for each other. So, you know, there is a lot of vibe, lot of talk. lot, lot of energy in this connection, in this marriage. Lot of heat also. I'm already sweating here. Such a hot connection it is. So watch out, and there is more heat coming. King of Rods, fire, fire, fire. I bet this is the person you will marry. They are an opposite of yours. So you guys will be very attracted to each other. At the same time, this person will push your buttons, friends. So, you know, take your time. Take your time with them and be patient. I also feel this person could be your twin flame, the person you will marry. And it feels like, you know, there might be some blocks in this marriage or delays, but eventually you guys will get married. And I do see that, you know, once you get married, there will be no stopping you. No one can come in between you. But before, there might be some delays in getting married to each other because of the sexual chemistry, because of different religion, culture, because, like, you know, you guys are like, this is not a normal kind of a relationship in the sense, like, you know, maybe this person was married before, or you were married before, or, you know, there is some issue, like, you know, that, you know, there will be certain delays, certain, this is not a traditional kind of a relationship. This is something that breaks the path, that breaks the norm, this marriage. But the marriage itself is very strong. The connection itself is very strong. You guys are opposites, and people might even oppose because they see, like, you are fire, they are water. So the people will be like, you guys are so different, why are you marrying together? But this love is unstoppable, this connection is unstoppable. You guys will definitely be very protective of each other, and even jealous if someone else tries to come in between you guys. A lot of passion is there. Very, very intense marriage. Very intense relationship. Five of Rods. Yes, conflict. I do feel that the person you will marry, you know, there might be some, you know, legal issues in the sense, like, you know, this person could be a lawyer. So they do those things, you know, a surgeon, a doctor. So, you know, you generally deal with those kind of things, you know. Cases and all those kind of things. Another thing I'm feeling is, like, the person you will marry, they are your opposites. You know, they are opposites. You guys are opposite, but there will be a lot of chemistry because of that. A lot of, you know, a lock and key kind of a relationship. You guys are made for each other, perfect, but you guys will drive each other mad also at the same time. And another thing is, there will be competition in this connection, in the way, like, you know, when you meet this person, there is another person in your life already, or you have another marriage proposal. So there is competition. One of you has to fight, or both of you will have to fight for this marriage and this connection. Or maybe you met this person in the past when you were younger as a twin flame, as a soulmate, but it didn't work out. So later ahead in the years, you will meet them again and get married to them. So finally, you know, you guys will meet. So there will be certain delays, certain competition, but it will go in your favor. And I do feel this person is very rich. They are very, very recognized in their, I feel both of you are very recognized in their work, in your business, in your work field, in your careers, you know. And this marriage will be a talk of the town. This marriage will be a talk of the town, absolutely. Let's see how this marriage will be, how your person, the person you will marry, how they are. Let's see that. Ooh, look at that. Love. I come into the practice of seeing the good in all things. Wow, there is so much love in this connection. I feel sometimes you may doubt, you know, is it just sexual attraction? Is it just that, you know, do they love me? Yes, of course. Sometimes your person may also doubt, do you love them? Yes, there is intense love in this connection. In fact, this might be a love marriage for some of you. A love marriage that has, you know, won over a lot of battles, a lot of challenges, overcome a lot of challenges. Let's see what else. By the book, 11-11. So for some of you, it could be a twin flame connection, a very intense connection, a very destined and fated marriage, something that you guys are dreaming, something you are manifesting, something you are calling for. Yes, 11-11, doing things by the book. Yes, this marriage was something that, you know, may seem different for people, like you guys are from different religions, different culture, maybe you guys are from the same sex relationship, whatever it is, you know, you guys, your marriage will actually be more traditional than any other marriage, you know, in the way like you guys will have a very strict loyalty for each other, very intense passion, very intense commitment towards each other, and very intense sexual chemistry with each other. So this may be a different kind of a marriage, but this may be a love marriage for some of you, but it will be very, very, very intense. It will be very traditional. It will be like all the ingredients of a marriage are there, perfect. And new life, yes, this marriage will bring a new life into your life, a new sense of excitement, a new beginning. Also, this could be a second chapter for some of you, like if you were divorced, if you were married in the past, or if you dated them in the past, it didn't work out, this might be the person you will get married to, and again a new phase of life will start for you. Another thing I'm feeling is maybe this was your soulmate or someone you dated in the past or loved in the past, but it didn't work out then. Again, somewhere in the future, you will get married to them and it will be a new start, a second start, a new exciting start for both of you. So how your marriage will be, let's see that. How your married life will be with this person. Ooh, cat. So yeah, this you know, there will be a lot of excitement, a lot of curiosity to know, you know, how you feel, how you think. A lot of communications will be there. You guys will, you know, invest in looking good. You guys could be models, actors, you know, creative people, or you guys are from the same profession. So there is a lot of talk, you know, things to talk about. There is a lot of discussions, lot of curiosity, lot of love, lot of care. You know, cats are like very loving, you know, they sleep well, they eat well, there is comfort, there is luxury, you know. And ooh, oh my god, the lion. Super, super passionate, very, very powerful connection. You guys will be like power couples. You know, you guys are perfect for each other and no one else can deal with you, your energy, your charisma, your sexual chemistry, except you both. No one can handle such a relationship except you both. So this will be a very passionate connection. You guys both could be fire signs. You both could be opposites that are together. But whatever it is, there is intense love in this connection, intense passion, very intense, very comforting, very loving, very deep relationship, marriage, very deep. Let's see your romance angels and then your charms. It is safe for you to love. Open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of love. Wow, you have two love cards. So definitely, yes, it is safe for you to love. If you are getting, I feel you are already getting ready to love, fall in love, and that's exactly what you need to do. You know, keep an open heart. Love is coming your way, you guys. If this person has hurted you in the past, forgive them. Keep an open heart. Love is going to surprise you. Love is coming your way. Let's see your charms, friends. Who is the person you are going to marry? Option number 2. Who is the person you will marry? Option number 2. Okay, let's see. I think those are enough charms. Alright, lots of initials you got, and this got stuck in the letter P. Interesting. Very interesting. Wow. So there is these initials are there. There is Peg. So you know Peggy. I keep getting the name Peggy. Maybe this person's name is the person you will marry. Their name could be Peggy. और यू नो I don't know, their name could be, you know, Jewel, you know, something with Jewel. Their name could be like, you know, leg is also coming, so leg could be important for some of you. Gel, you know, they are someone who gels with you. They are someone who will be a perfect fit with you, you know, like one body, one heart, one soul. So PJ, their initials could be PJ, or you know, I keep getting the name Janelia. Love, their name could be Love, their name could be Lucky. J is also important, like John. And I'm not getting any names actually right now except John. I don't know why, that's weird. So let's see, the pink, yeah, the pink hat is like this person, you know, there will be a lot of romance in this connection as well as passion. This is a very romantic connection as well as a very passionate connection. The bouquet, you might meet this person, you know, bouquet is like, you know, this person might first date you and propose you, like, you know, as a love marriage. You might date this person and then get married. They might also send you some flowers, even when they are courting you or trying to date, you know, get married to you, and that will be important. This is like a gift, a blessing coming into your life. Message in a bottle, yes, lots of deep feelings. You know, this marriage, there will be the feelings run so deep for each other that you guys will really take some time, you know. You know, you guys, I don't know how to say, the love is so deep that you may not even know how deep your love is for each other. Very deep connection, loyalty, dog. This is a very loyal connection. Time, yes. This person has, I feel like divine timing is important in this connection. Like, you may meet this person, but you may not get married immediately with them. There might be certain delays, like 2 months, two months, 4 months, 2 years or something. And then you might get married to them. And Lotus, yes, a very spiritual relationship, a twin flame connection, a very strong relationship. You guys are spiritually connected with each other. Rose, another, again, a high vibration romance, a very, very deep romance, a destined marriage, you know, twin flames, made with love. Yeah, this person is completely, you know, I feel this person will give you a lot of gifts, gold, you know, jewelry, cars, you know, bouquets, flowers. They want a gift to you because that's what they are coming. Twin flames again. This is a very, very, very important connection. This marriage is fated, friends. Lion, and look at that. Lion. Twice. And I shuffled the charms in front of you. I don't even know. There are tons of charms there. I can't pick up from them. They are so tiny. I can't even try and, you know, choose from them. It's impossible. Wow. Very, very... very powerful connection. The person you will marry are very physically fit. They are very good looking and they could be a fire sign, two of yours. Yes, there might be some delays before you guys get married. You might even doubt, like, you know, this can work, this relationship, because it is so intense. I also feel that Asia, this person could be from Asia. You guys both could be from Asia. Dreams, yes, you will meet this person or see them first in your dreams because you are already manifesting this person. What else? Hope, yeah, remain hopeful because this person is coming very quickly into your life. Star, yes, a very, very fated connection. For some of you, this person could be a celebrity or someone who is widely known in famous in their work, in their career. Someone who is, both of you could be celebrities, famous people, Six of Cups, soulmate, childhood romance. You may have dated this person earlier. You may have broken away, but eventually you will get married to them. Karmic, yes. This connection is destined. even if they are your twin flame, you are destined to get married. Even if you guys are like, you know, you may have been married once before, or you went through some karmic issues. Maybe your person was married or divorced. Maybe they went through a heartache or very terrible breakup, but eventually you guys are destined to be together. Style, yes, this person is very stylish. This marriage will be very stylish. Wow, friends, what a reading. I just love it. And thank you so much. Make sure to subscribe Magic Wands Tarot, like and share. Join us on Insta to buy a personal reading. Visit our website. This is Mystic C saying bye-bye for now. So for those who chose option number 3, let us see who you will get married to, friends. And this is a charms reading, and we'll see your charms shortly. These are your oracle messages. You're going to look in detail who you are going to get married. So I'm going to spill all the details for you. Let's see pile number 3. Who is it you are going to get married? All right, friends, you are recently, you went through a breakup recently, I feel. Either someone left you or you left somebody. I feel pile number 3, you moved out of a relationship or a marriage or some past connection recently, and you're still trying to recover from that. You know, you're still trying to heal a broken heart. You're still trying to get over somebody from your past. You're still trying to heal yourself. I feel you guys are very, very sweet. You guys are very emotional about certain things of your past, even now. I feel maybe this connection was old, you know, like 7 years, 10 years, 5 years, 3 years, 2 years, maybe 1 or 2 month old. But it was, you were very attached with this person. So you are still trying to come out of an attachment to somebody. I think some of you may still be waiting for a current or past connection to come back or get married to you. I think you are, I don't know, pile number 3, it feels like nostalgia. You're feeling nostalgic. You want somebody. You are pining for somebody. It's like you're, even if you can have anybody in life, you want this somebody. You want this person you have attached to yourself on. You know, you like somebody and you want them. Even you still love them, even if you have moved away from them, moved on from them. So all this, I feel like you are trying to heal. You are still in love with somebody, but you are trying to heal. You are trying to come out of it, recover from it. So that's your current energy. Let's see who you will marry. Let's see that. All right. You are going to marry someone very, very wise, someone very deep, someone very intelligent, someone very knowledgeable and spiritually wise, you know. You are going to marry someone who is very much into spirituality, as you know, astrology, or even if not, they are very much, you know, they know a lot about life. They have seen a lot of life. They are very intelligent. They are very, very wise. This person you will marry, they could be a Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus person. I also feel the person you will marry is very deep. They talk less, but they know a lot. They could be a teacher, a mentor, a guide. For some of you, this person could come into your life as a spiritual teacher, or a mentor, or a guide. I also feel the person you will marry, they could be someone who speaks very less. They don't like to talk much because they are very, you know, but they know a lot many things. They are very intelligent. They are very wise. And they take their time. They are somebody who takes their time. They don't rush. You know, fools rush in where angels fear to tread. This person takes their time. They are like an angel. They know when to act, when not to act. Also, the person you will marry, they will come as a guiding light in your life, as a support. Or you might be a spiritual mentor, a guiding light in the person's life, in your future spouse's life. Very interesting. Very, very interesting. Let's see what else. Who is the person you will marry? Oh my God, the High Priestess. Yes, the person you will marry will be someone very, very telepathic. They are very different from everybody else, you know. They are intelligent. They have a high telepathy. They are very psychically intuitive. They could be an artist, a poet, a writer. They could be even someone who does, you know, jewelry making. They could be a researcher. They could be a scholar, someone, a philosopher, a poet. They could be a media person, you know, someone who directs movies or story writer. I also feel they could be someone who is into Reiki, spirituality, astrology, you know. Very, very, very intuitive person, very deep person, very wise, very, very wise. Someone who is very respected also in whatever they are doing. I also feel the person you will marry, they will, you know, they will reach to their topmost success in life, to the, you know, in their career, they will be very successful. People will look up to them. You will also look up to them, or they will look up to you. So it's a wonderful connection. It is like, you know, the person you will marry is this hermit, and you guys are this high priestess. So you guys are, you guys also have similar energy, very intuitive, very wise, old souls, you know, very perfect for each other. And this person will come into your life at a perfect time when you really need each other's support, each other's wisdom. That's exactly when you are going to get and meet this person, and they will help you, and you both will help each other actually. So let's see, who is the person you will marry? Ace of Pentacles, someone who is someone who will be an innovator. I feel the person you will marry, they will be, you know, someone, they might be very uniquely gifted, like they start a business which is done only by them. They could be a YouTuber, they could be an entrepreneur, and they are also very lucky with money. They are very rich with money. They could have a lot of money of their own. They could be born in, the person you will marry, they are born in a very rich family. I also feel they come from a very, very well-to-do family, very strong, financially rich and stable family. But even then, they will still be working very hard and bringing some new, something new in this world, you know. The person you will marry, they could be someone who is an astrologer, who is in, you know, they do something unique. They do something unique, like tattoo maker, you know, jewelry designer, graphic designer, media designer. They could be into astrology, Reiki, healer. They could be a spiritual mentor, someone who takes people a travel, you know, guide, someone who takes you to mountains, you know. They could be into hotel management or hotelier also. But they are very rich, friends. They are very rich. They have a lot of money. And I think money keeps coming to them. It's like whatever they start, they get very lucky. Very lucky. And I feel the goddess of prosperity and the gods of prosperity, Lord Ganesha, Lord Goddess Lakshmi, is extremely blessing this person and this marriage. This will be a very, very perfect union, and there will be a lot of prosperity from this marriage, from this connection and marriage of alliance, you know. It will bring prosperity. I also feel you might meet this person when through your work or through your career, or while you are studying, you might meet this person there. I also feel that your parents might, you know, families might be business associates, or they might know each other, and they might help you connect with each other. Let's see what else. Who is the person you will marry? Lovers. Wow, the person you will marry, they are very loving, they are very supportive, and they will respect you a lot. You know, if they are a man, they respect you as a woman, and you know, whatever, they will be very respectful. They know their boundaries. They know how to support you. They know how to support you emotionally, financially, mentally. They will be a guiding light. You will depend on this person. You can count on this person. I do feel that, you know, this person, this marriage will be like a spiritual awakening for you and this person. You guys will become even more better after this marriage. More awakened, more conscious. And this will be a, you know, God is guiding, you know, very fated, a destined connection. I also feel that this person you will marry, they will take care of you. This person is someone, you know, if you are sick, they will sit beside you until you are well. They will not leave your bedside, you know. They will keep with you. They will stand with you through thick and thin. And that's exactly what you want. Someone who is wise, someone who is protective, someone who stays with you, who doesn't give up, especially in tough times. Because you have seen people who gave up on you. Who gave up on you, especially when the things got tough. You know, when pressure rises, most people run away. This person won't. So you will really like that about them. You guys will be each other's support. Look at that. You guys will support each other through many thick and thin times, you know, many difficult times. You guys will be each other's support, each other's foundation, the rock. You guys are amazing. This person is amazing, friends. Very nice. Page of Pentacles, yes. Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, and a Scorpio person. They could be a Scorpio, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus person. I do feel that the person you will marry, you will notice one thing about them. They don't rush. They have a lot of peace. They have a natural rhythm in them. They are very patient. They will never rush in, you know. They are never rushing, you know. Even if you may sometimes feel like this person takes too long to act. This person takes too long to make a decision. But they are very wise. They know when to act and when not to act. But one of the things you may find irritating about them is they take too long. They are very patient. Sometimes you will be like, how can you have so much patience? Why don't you ever get irritated, you know? You may feel that way about them. But they have the patience of the oceans. They have the patience of the sky. Also, you may have an age gap, a significant age gap with this person. Also, you may be from the different, different age, different religion and culture also, and a significant age gap also. Or you guys may be very, very young when you get married. Or you guys have a huge gap, you know. Although age gaps don't matter, but for other people, you know, they may say, oh, this is a lot of age gap between you and them. But they are your mentor. They are your teacher. You are their guiding light also. Two of Swords. Yes, this person will, the person you will marry, they listen to your intuition. They don't follow their mind. They don't follow their heart. They listen to their intuition. That is why they take time. They are patient. They don't hurry. You know, they are not egoistic. They are someone who is open to their intuition, to the higher, you know, laws of nature, energy, attraction, laws of attraction. They understand those things. King of Cups, yes. This person is, you know, they are very mature. Their love is like ripe fruits, you know, which are very sweet. Have you ever eaten a very ripe mango? Yesterday only, someone gifted me mangoes and they were very sweet. You know, they have trees in their home where they have mangoes growing on it, and they gifted me those mangoes because they were very sweet and they wanted to share the sweetness of that mango. It was ripened on the tree. It was very sweet. So this will be a very mature and loving kind of a person. Very mature. You can always count on them. Always giving you support. Always giving you financial support also. This person is someone, you know, who will not ask where you are going, why you want this, why you do that. No, they are like understanding. I know, I understand, I care. That kind of a person. And they will have a very strong, I don't know why, but pile number three, your person you will marry, they have a strange relationship with their father. Maybe they are very close to their father or just not at all close to their father. So some sort of a relationship they have with their father. Or you may also have some issues with your father. Very close to them or not at all close to them. Nine of Rods. Yeah, I feel the person you will marry, they have also faced a lot of challenges in their life. They have seen the worst in their life, and that is why they have become very mature. They have become very patient. They have become very loving. And that is exactly, they will understand your challenges, and they will have sympathy and love and support and compassion for you. Rather than leaving you in the middle, they will stand with you and face the storm. So very beautiful marriage, very deep, very wise, you know, it's like the sunshine. It's beautiful, this marriage. let's see who is the person you will marry. What is their core quality? Peace. Wow. See, very peaceful connection, very peaceful person. You know, this person will have no ego, no drama. You know, the only thing is they take time. They are slow. They are not very open to technology. They don't like change much. They like to live a comfortable life. They don't enjoy changes much. So that way you may find them like, oh, they are not very open to technology. They are, you know, old souls, very old souls. They like rock and roll music. They like classic music. They like, you know, the old, good old music. They like the good old home-cooked meals rather than going out. Very beautiful, very peaceful person, very peaceful connection. Let's see what else. Soulmates, yes, this person is your soulmate. You guys will meet at a very important time when you both need each other. You will be a spiritual mentor. They will be a guiding light in your life. Thinker, number 44, yes, this person thinks a lot. They are a thinker. They are. They could be a writer. They could be someone who writes a lot, who is a poet, who is a writer, a journalist, a media person, a storyteller, a motivational speaker, an astrologer, an artist. You know, they think a lot. This person is a thinker. And they will think about everything, you know, what you like, what you don't like. And they will write you love letters. I see them writing love letters, love songs for you. Wonderful. So let's see how your married life will be with this person. How your married life will be. Hedgehog, wow. Wow. I feel, you know, when you meet this person, you know, this person, this marriage, you know, this person will very be, they will protect you. I don't know why. They are like a parent towards you. They are very protective about you. Like, you know, no one will be able to hurt you. Not even their family or friends or anything. They want to protect you. Like, you know, come here. Let me protect you. Look at this. It's like this. They want to protect you. Look at this. Come here. I'll protect you. So this marriage, you know, you will protect each other. You will have each other's back. You will be very, you know, you know, no one can come between you and this person. That's the kind of marriage you will have. And, you know, this person will have, will be very thorny outside for others. But for you, they have a very kind heart. Very, very kind heart. And they will always protect you. And look at that elixir, yes. This marriage will be like a lifeline for both of you. It will be like this, you know, like heaven coming into your life, like light coming into your life after a lot of darkness, after a lot of challenges, tribulations. This marriage will be like elixir. It will be like, how do I say this? Like heaven, you know, like heaven coming into your life, like peace coming into your life, like sweetness coming into your life. Very, very blissful marriage. Let's see your romance angels and then your charms. Oh my God, look at that. Wow, goosebumps. You guys are both soulmates. Look at that. This person you will marry is your soulmate. And maybe you have met, you've wanted to marry somebody else. Maybe right now also you want to marry somebody else. But the person you will actually marry or end up marrying is your soulmate. And yes, yes, they are your soulmate. So you may, you may want, you know, you are in love with somebody else right now. But the person you will marry is somebody else, but they are perfect for you. So let's see your charms, friends. Let's see your charms. Option number 3, who will they marry? All right, let's see. Wow, so yeah, see the ex came out. So you're definitely wanting or waiting for an ex, you know, to get married to you. So definitely, but you know, maybe this person is your ex and they come back. But I feel for some of you, this is a new person and they are perfect. They are much better than those you are missing. And what else? Your person's name could be Sunny or, you know, Saisha or, you know, Santosh, something like that. I keep getting the name Sunny, Annie, you know, Annie and Nancy. The person's name could be Nancy. You know, that could be the name. Also, this person could be someone who is a musician, a saxophonist, someone who plays an instrument or something. That could also be there. So the initials are S-A and N-N and X. Also, they could be from America. I keep getting USA also. So maybe they are from some different city or country. Number 15 is important. That could be their birth date. White, peace. And you saw how the bead jumped out. Peace. This is a very peaceful marriage. Very peaceful connection. You know, there is no fight and arguing in this marriage. Very peaceful, very loving, understanding at its highest. And butterfly, a positive change. This marriage will be a positive change in your life. The bird nest, you guys will be like lovebirds, and this person will provide you with a home, with a family, you know, with a roof, with money, with food, everything you need, emotional support, love. They want to give to you. I don't know why, but they want to give everything to you. Anything you want, even if it's diamonds, even if it's the moon, they will give it to you. Casablanca, yes. You know, this is like this person and you will build something together, a house, a family, a legacy. The bow, yes, you guys could be twin flames. You guys have a very deep soulmate connection. Attachment, yes, this person will be very attached and very protective about you. You are also currently very attached with somebody, the ex. But yeah, growth, this marriage will develop very deep, you know. You guys will, you know, grow as best friends into supporters of each other. Very, very supportive. And look at that, from two leaves to three leaves. Your fortune will also grow. This marriage will bring you fortune. This marriage will bring you success. The blue car, you know, a lot of mental connection. This person will be like your spiritual guide. Or you guys are both each other's spiritual support, emotional support. The iron, it has been coming a lot this time in this reading. The iron is like this person will help you in any area of your life. You know, they will walk before you, making things better. And look at that, the smile. Yeah, there is a lot of love, emotional connection, romance in this relationship. Heart, yeah, this person will heal you of any past heartache. Inspiration, this marriage will inspire many other people to get married. Lover, yes, I do feel you are dealing with somebody right now, but someone new is coming. Mother, yeah, mother energy. This person will be like your mother or very caring of you, very, very caring. You will also care for them a lot. Four of you, very, sorry friends. My throat, friends. It's getting better. It's getting better. Yeah, you can see it now. But yeah, it's taking some time. Patience. Four of you. Very patient person. Not rushing in. Taking their time. That's exactly what it is. We all need some time. Patience. Rest. Six of you. A very soothing relationship. A very soothing relationship. Again and ex. Whew. Wow. Again, an ex-lover. Maybe some of you might end up marrying your ex-lover. But I see that for most of you, you will marry somebody else. Although there is a chance of you getting married to an ex, but it might be somebody else actually that you end up with. Mouse. Very loving, very hardworking person, very hardworking person. So that's it for now, friends. Do let me know if you enjoyed this reading, if it resonated with you. And to do subscribe Magic Wands Tarot, like and share, join us on Insta. To buy a personal reading, visit our website. And that's it for now, friends. This is Mystic C saying bye-bye.